My feelings of love.
This isn't four-star cooking, this is Burger King, and with us you have it your way. You know, you don't want tomatoes, you don't get the tomatoes.
When somebody sees a cake, the thing you see first is the frosting. Ooh, that's deep.
On stage, we don't feel like other bands. We feel, you know, we feel 7 feet tall. So we dress, we make sure we are 7 feet tall.
New York City, 1973. Four local boys, Gene Simmons, Paul Stanley, Peter Chris, and Ace Frehley, decide to form a band. Stanley comes up with the name Kiss because it sounds familiar, sounds right. They design their own logo, outfits, and stage show. They even borrow money to rent halls to perform in. Many critics dismiss them as a novelty act. Some novelty.
And 21 albums later, Kiss is still one of the hottest hard rock bands around. Outwardly, the Kiss of today is far removed from the original. Chris and Frehley have left, and the trademark makeup has disappeared. But the style of music is essentially the same, and the band members still want nothing as much as the chance to rock and roll all night.
Some people think there's something to complain about when you reach this kind of success. I mean, we were lucky enough to have a dream that we saw come true, so we have no complaints. We're having a great time. At this point, we don't do this because we have to do this. We do this because we love doing it.
You get to live once, and I'm not, you know, I don't know if I'm in the fast lane or just the illegal lane. I'm not quite sure, but I mean, we're having a lot of fun, mm-hmm. And maybe we're lucky, but boy, this is a good life.
The thing that separates Kiss fans from a lot of other fans is that, really, I don't think that our fans are concerned with what this year's fad is. Nobody wants this year's hula hoop except, you've got a lot of bands that come out of England and more power to them, but a lot of those bands...
It's not the hula hoop, it's the air that's inside
well,
it, right?
Yeah, well, you know...
I just thought that up. I thought it was...
Brilliant.
Great.
You know, you have a band from England that makes it because they have a teapot on their head, you know, and they're great this month, but next month nobody's heard of them. So I think that our fans kind of stick by us because they know that I mean, we do what we do, and we're going to keep doing it.
We have a great time. We're not writing about nostalgia. We're not writing fantasy. We're writing our idea of reality. May not be everybody's idea of reality, but that's what makes horse races, is different things for different people. We don't tell people to live like us, but for anybody who wants to know what it's like without participating, it's fun.
tell you a funny story is our drummer at the time, Peter Criss, was very depressed about, well, things aren't going so well. This was only after four months of rehearsal, and we were putting on one of our first concerts in New York City, a hall that we rented. We advertised for it and everything. So I rented a limousine, and we went to this place with girlfriends, equipment, everything, in this stretch. It was like a stretch.
Mercedes.
Yeah, with everything in there. Went up to this sleazy prostitute hotel on 43rd and 6th in New York City. You get out and bums are there, but we came in style.
That's right.
Go up to the second floor of this like sleazebag hotel, play our hearts out. You know, it was a great way to start. One of the first shows we ever did, limousines.
We always thought of ourselves as a band playing an arena or a stadium. You know, bands try to do that nowadays, which is real nice, but I think it's definitely the right attitude. I mean, when we started off, we were a band that never played clubs. In our minds, we were always playing, we were always headlining, and we were always at Madison Square Garden. Whoa!
Even if you don't like Kiss, you'd probably love their live shows. Every concert is a larger-than-life spectacle, complete with fireworks, dry ice, motorized risers, and 50-foot signs. Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley are first-rate entertainers. They know how to draw the audience in and how to get them involved. The music is secondary, as Stanley readily admits.
We're not Rembrandt. We're not trying to paint, and we're certainly not Michelangelo trying to do the Sistine Chapel.
No, but you're creative. Obviously, what you do is a creative thing.
Well, I mean, it's fun. It's creative, but we're more involved with the charge that we get from doing it than trying to create art. The only ceilings we want to paint are the Holiday Inn ceilings.
Yeah. I don't think you should ever take yourself so seriously that you're really in awe of what you're doing. You know, I mean, what we're doing, we're just a bunch of guys from New York City who have a lot of fans who are behind us.
Right.
And we do what we do, and I think we do it well.
Yeah, I think you've been doing a great job at delivering the product, which is Kiss material.
You know, this isn't four-star cooking, this is Burger King, and with us you have it your way. You know, you don't want tomatoes, you don't get the tomatoes.
Right. And there's a lot more people out there that eat at Burger King than eat at four-star restaurants.
Absolutely. You know, I mean, we're a people's band. We've never tried to be a critic's band. If I was going to paint the Sistine Chapel, I'd do it with a roller. You know, I'm not a fine artist, folks.
Everybody only sees the final result, which is the showmanship and getting up on stage and doing it. Everything starts and ends with a song for us, you know. Boy, we're getting serious. All of a sudden, we got very serious. Ooh. Everything starts with an idea, a song. You pick up a musical instrument, and then from there...
You break it.
You know, we get into the embellishment. The truth is, though, that when somebody sees a cake, the thing you see first is the frosting. Ooh, that's deep. And you know, if you look at a cake and say, hey, it's all frosting, it's true. Right underneath the frosting, though, we've got cake. We've got stuff, songs. You know, even though KISS scientists have been hard at work for many, many years trying to put flash pods into our records, all you get are songs. Somebody out there has bought those, who knows, 50, 60, hundreds of billions of records or whatever. It's been 21 albums later, and all that's been on the vinyl are songs.
Thank you. we return to make up or not to make up. That is the question. Without heroes,
world without heroes. How long have you been a Kiss fan?
8.5 years.
Why? What's so great about Kiss? 9 years, for a long time.
They're great. That's all there is to it.
They're great. Why?
Because they are. They give you more of your mind than anybody.
Best singing, best guitarist, man.
Yeah,
they're
everything.
They know it, man. Toronto's going to know it.
Listen, they got class. That's it. They got everything.
What about these costumes that you're wearing? I mean, they're absolutely remarkable.
Kiss, man. We got them off and ripped them off.
Homemade.
How long did you work on this one, for example?
4.5 months.
Are you serious? Oh, but would you design it especially for the concert?
Yeah.
So you're going to wear it.
In fact, I've been waiting for this concert for I don't know how long.
Aw, that's amazing.
Four years.
That's right here.
Really?
Yeah. So,
the same with your costume? You've been working on it for a long time?
Yeah, definitely. For sure. Yeah. Boots took a long time, too. They're the greatest.
Okay. Show some fire.
All right, yeah. So you're all going to be there, obviously.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Well, we'll see you there, okay?
For sure.
Thanks a lot. Okay, hold on. Oh, excuse me. Could I talk to you for a second as well? Hi. How long have you been a Kiss fan for?
7 years.
How old are you?
11.
Oh, well, when you were 4 years old?
Yeah.
Why? What's so great about them?
Well, I like their act, their stage show, you know.
All right.
Do you dress like this often?
Yeah, every second day.
Fans love to imitate their rock and roll heroes. Even today, 5 years after Kiss members have shed their masks, fans continue to dress up like the band of old. In January 1983, a couple of months before the makeup came off, the New Music's Jeannie Becker had a chance to talk with Paul Stanley and Gene Simmons about the Kiss image.
Do you ever yearn for the day when you just, you know, scrub off the makeup and you get up there as a band without
the
facade?
I don't think so. I mean, why? You know, you can almost ask the same thing of Superman. Why doesn't he take off that outfit and just sort of come out and do the things? Because it wouldn't be Superman. Kiss is Kiss because of all the special things that we do, that we choose to do. We don't have to do it. We make our own rules, and we like this. This is, you know, how you dress is how you feel, and on stage we don't feel like other bands. We feel, you know, we feel 7 feet tall, so we dress. We make sure we are 7 feet tall.
Things devoid of grace, where you don't know what you're after, or if something's after you, and you don't know why you don't know the world without heroes.
Obviously, the first question is, what inspired you to take it off?
We reached a point after 10 years where you just want to keep going forward. And people don't keep the same hairstyles, and when you change different things, it doesn't mean that you change who you are. You just change things to be more comfortable and to keep the same level of enthusiasm and energy. I mean, obviously we got to be true to what we believe in, because that's basically what Kiss is all about, is doing what we think is right. And when it didn't feel like we should be wearing the makeup anymore, we took it off.
Was there ever a moment where you were a little bit afraid of actually taking the makeup off, like maybe the fans wouldn't respond that well?
Everything has a calculated risk involved. And when we first started the band, when we did the first photo session, the record company was saying, well, don't you guys want to shoot the cover without makeup? And obviously there's a risk in everything you do, but we're pretty good judges of what we should be doing, and it seems like we made the right decision.
I think it's more frenzied, it's more exciting. The band is stronger than it's ever been, and we're going out now with like a whole new feeling, a whole new urge to kill, you know, on stage, and we do.
I remember Simmons, though, sitting in the back of a limo while a compatriot of mine, Jeannie Becker, was interviewing you and he a few years ago, before the makeup came off, saying that Kiss was a comic book. It was like Superman, you know. You don't take the tights off Superman.
That's
you don't
right.
take the makeup off.
You take the tights off Lois Lane is what you do.
So what made you decide to step out of the world of comic books?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I still see us as larger than life or whatever we were before. You know, I mean, nothing's really changed.
Scrubbing off the makeup did rejuvenate the band's career. Lick It Up The first album to feature their new look was dubbed A Worthy Comeback.
Don't